In our study of thermodynamics, calorimetry is one of the more important topics. And so under that broader category, we're going to look at specific heat and thermochemistry as well, which is just a branch of chemistry that is derived from our measurements in calorimetry. Okay, so calorimetry is just the experimental study of heat transfer. Okay, just the measuring how heat moves from one place to the other. And so in general, what you're going to use is a coffee cup calorimeter. There are more insulating calorimeters out there, including bomb calorimeters and vacuum-based and more foam-based. There's all sorts of calorimeters that you can use. And in most labs, for expense purposes, calorimeters made of styrofoam are used. And so we've got a stirrer here and then a thermometer that measures the temperature change in the water that will also go through the top of the cup. Okay, and so we're going to derive our basis for calorimetry from the first law of thermodynamics that says that the Q of the system is going to be equal to, and that's the change, the flow of heat of the system is going to be equal to the negative of that of the surroundings. And so we might put several systems within our cup. We might put a chunk of metal, an object, all right? We might put a reaction, reagent materials, reactant materials within there and measure the temperature change. However we measure, the temperature change that we're actually measuring is going to be the water temperature change. So our surroundings are going to be the temperature change of the water. And so one of the things about the system losing heat, there's another factor we have to consider, is that the heat lost by the system is not exactly equal to that of the water, but of a calorimeter constant. So of all the heat that is transferred by the system, some of that is going to be lost to the calorimeter or absorbed from the calorimeter and the greater surroundings, not just the water that we measure. So we have to take that into account when we measure the heat transfer. Okay, so let's look at determination of specific heat capacity. Okay, so our formula for this is Q is mass times the specific heat. So this is generally grams, that's mass. This is generally joules per gram per degree Celsius. Okay, so grams times degree Celsius on bottom for units, and it's just a constant for every material that we might see. And then times the change in temperature, noting that the change in means final state minus initial state. And so for temperature then, that's just temperature final, temperature initial. Okay, so we'll see that used here. And the units for that will be degrees Celsius, although Kelvin could be used since it is a change in and not a absolute temperature measurement. Fahrenheit may not be used because those degrees are different than those of the unit of degrees Celsius in the specific heat measurement. Okay, but our formula remains the same, MC times delta T. So let's do an example. Piece of metal at 100 degrees Celsius is added to a calorimeter with 50 milliliters of water at 20 degrees Celsius. The measured temperature change is 0.45 degrees Celsius. Okay, and so if the metal is 10 grams, what's the specific heat? And so what we have is a chance to use our formula that the Q of the metal, which is what we care about, the system, is equal to the negative Q of the water plus the calorimeter constant. Okay, and it says assume that the calorimeter is perfectly insulating, so we don't have to worry about that. A lot of times the problem will tell you that we're perfectly insulating, and so we can ignore that factor. And so what we've got then is the MC delta T of the metal is equal to the MC delta T, the negative MC delta T of the water. Okay, and so we'll put a little water subscript there and a little metal subscript just so we know to keep everything separate from one another. Okay, so for the mass of the metal, if the metal is 10 grams. So we have 10.0 grams for the metal. We are trying to solve for the specific heat of the metal, so we'll leave that in. And so if the measured temperature change is 0.45 degrees Celsius, that is a positive value. That means the final temperature after addition of the metal goes from 20 degrees Celsius to 20.45 degrees Celsius. So that's the final temperature minus the initial temperature of the metal, which was 100 degrees Celsius. So the final temperature of the water is 20.45. Final temperature of the metal is also 20.45 because they're all in the same equilibrated system. But the initial temperature of the metal was different than the water. So we have to say minus the initial minus 100 degrees. And all of that equals the negative of the mass of water. Well, 50 milliliters is 50 grams by definition. Okay, so 50 milliliters of water, 1 milliliter per 1 gram, 50.0 grams at 20 degrees Celsius. But we must continue on and say, well, MC delta T, the specific heat of water, is 4.18 joules per gram degree Celsius. So for water, little c of water, H2O, is 4.18 joules per gram degree Celsius. I'm going to need everyone in my class to memorize this quantity. That is something we need to know in order to do these problems for calorimetry. So memorize this specific heat of water, and we'll be able to use it in all the problems. Okay, so we've got specific heat of water, and then the change in temperature. Well, the temperature change of the water is given to us as 0.45 degrees Celsius, and that is a positive value overall. Okay, so picking that information out is very important to completing the problem. So then we isolate our terms and solve, parentheses first. Okay, we have to do, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. So parentheses first, find the temperature change, then you can do multiplication and division. When everything's said and done, the final value must be, I get 0.118 to three significant figures, which we should round to two significant figures, and our final answer, due to the limiting multiple here of 0.45. So there's two here, so we must round it to 0.120 or 0.12 joules per gram degree Celsius. So be sure that when you multiply everything out, you divide by 10 grams and then divide by the negative 79.55 grams that we get from this parentheses operation, so that we don't end up multiplying when we should divide. So make sure you get it in the calculator correctly and get the same answer.